Hey guys, it is Friar Trot here, and welcome to my channel, or welcome back to my channel. So hello, I do not post a lot when I'm at college, mostly for the reason that I do not have any of my ponies with me, even though I did actually post an unboxing video a month or two ago. Go check that out if you haven't. But this isn't just an average day for me. I will be driving to Western New York today from Pennsylvania for my college. I've done the drive before. It's really not that bad. It's only about 5 hours, which I know sounds bad for a lot of people, but I drive long distances a lot now to get to my two internships. So it's like nothing to me. But to make the trip a little bit more bearable, I am going to be stopping at two antique stores on my way. These are just ones that I found on Google. They seem to have good reviews. They're open when I'm going. So we are going to be on a hunt for some briar horses. Last time that I went to an antique shop, it was actually in my college town. We went to two, and I only found one briar horse in the whole entire trip. And it was a classic on that rearing Mustang mold for $35. So no way I would ever spend that amount of money on a beat up old classic, but it was exciting to see. So I got my Starbucks. It is a, oh my God, grande iced chai with vanilla streak and cold foam. The best Starbucks order. The only thing I really order from Starbucks. And then also a spinach feta egg white wrap. Best thing on Starbucks menu. But anyway, so I'm gonna go fill up my gas because I need to do that. I'm currently sitting in my university parking lot. And then we're gonna make the ride up there. It's only about, the first one's only about 2.5 hours. Bro, if you park next to me, that's gonna be so awkward. Oh, he did it. And then I'm not sure how far along the other one is. But pretty much I just wanted to break up the trip, and I really have no rush to get there. There's nothing exciting that we're doing today. Oh, did I tell you guys why I'm going upstate? My boyfriend goes to college up there. We've been doing long distance for 4 years, and we basically just have been switching off every semester of who goes to visit each other. Usually I go up earlier, in February, so I'm actually excited to go up when it's nice weather. So yeah, let's hope that we find some ponies. My goal of this trip is to find 5 briar horses, and I would love to find one reasonably priced enough and one that I love enough to buy. Just one. That is all I'm asking for. And from the looks of it, it's gonna be two massive antique malls. And I really just hope we find one in general so I can, this video will be worth it. So let's go do that. Okay guys, we just made it. There's always people in the parking lot, it's so awkward. This kind of is giving me more thrift store vibes than antique store, and those are very different vibes. But if not, still gonna go walk around. I really need to pee. It only took me about 2 hours and 15 minutes to get here, so not too bad. But yeah, the next one that I'm going to is apparently the biggest antique store in New York State. It's what it claimed on its website. So if this one's a flop, I won't be too upset. But fingers crossed, we could find something.
When I went on her page and seen her pictures, I said, "Oh, jump scare!"
Definitely not Briar, but still cool. Okay, just got back from inside, and it was a flop as expected. There was actually a flea market happening on the other side of the building that only happens on Fridays and Saturdays, so I guess I was pretty lucky to include that, but nothing briar related whatsoever. Hope you enjoyed the few little horsey things that I found, but I think I already said this in the last clip, but the next one I'm going to is apparently biggest antique shop in, or mall, I guess, in New York State. Said over 30,000 square feet of antiques. So if we don't find one freaking briar in there, I'm gonna be pretty disappointed. But let's hit the road and hope we find some ponies. Okay, hello. I just made it to the second store. I'm sweating right now, but I don't want my car on. It's really freaking hot here. This part of the traveling wasn't as fun, I think, because I was really hungry the whole time and I have to pee again. And also my low tire pressure went off and I don't think it's good. So now I need to check that out. Also, update on my tire pressure. I actually have a mini tire pump in my car. So I'm gonna do that after I walk around. I just think this is pretty. Guys, we found some. Yep, 3. $20. Here's a briar. Oh my goodness. So we are up to 4 briar horses. Also, I'm whispering, it is so quiet. Our search continues because this place is huge and I keep getting lost. Alright. Hey, baby. We got some Schlake and the Briar set. There are so many heartlands around. This is the second time I found like a big group of them. Another horse cock. And we found a Misty. And some knockoffs. Briar horse. Okay, look what I just found that was completely hidden. Oh my goodness. You can spot that yellow box from anywhere.
Only $25? Wait a minute.
Stop, I actually really want to get him. Like, that was kind of nice. And I don't have a Missouri Fox Trotter. Only $25. You're coming home with me. Okay, we are like hitting the jackpot now.
Do you have the Andalusian family?
More than I would pay, but pretty cool with the original box. And then this Appy family, they're actually really nice. And I'm 99% sure if this is a Briar elephant. Only $3. Oh my goodness, guys. That was so fun. So, okay, let me get in the car and then I'll talk about what happened. But pony and another pony secured. Okay, I'm gonna try and talk really fast just because it's really hot in my car, but I don't want the car on. You know the deal. So, okay, completely got our goal. We saw like probably 10 or 15 Briar horses and one even fully in the box. They were so nice in there. So I ended up getting that little family Arabian foal, or proud Arabian foal. No, yes, proud Arabian foal. And he was listed for $10, which like not really worth it, but he was from the 60s and he was glossy and I was like, oh, cute. Yeah, I was just like, I'm just gonna get him, just like, because I at that point I thought I wasn't gonna be able to find anything else, so I was like, I need to come home with something, gotta complete the goal. But then I found that new in box Missouri Fox Trotter. The box that he's from 1999, and he just looks like a nice dude, and I don't have any Missouri Fox Trotters in my showstring, so why not? And he was listed for $25. And then apparently they were having a sale for like 20% off or something. Everything over $10. Okay, I'm like walking around with the horse in the box and I have to like ask later to get the horse in the glass case. She was like, oh, like, do you want me to hold that for you? And this is apparently like the owner of the store. She was a boss because one of the workers there, he's probably around my age, he was following me around and like talking to me every chance he could. And he was the one who helped me get the little foal out of the glass case. And he was like, oh, you like horses? Like, I rode a horse once, like, blah, blah. And he was just like, I'm gonna miss you when you're gone. Like, I'm gonna cry. Like, you gotta tell me that you're gonna come back. I was like, like, I'm not from around here, but okay. Oh, he also, I'm wearing a shirt from a restaurant from where I go to school. And he's like, oh, do you work there? Like, that was the first thing he said to me. I was like, no, like, this isn't from around here. I was like, oh, there's a Marita's around here. I don't know. He was talking my ear off. He just, every chance I ran into him, and I ran into him like 3 or 4 times, and every single time he would talk to me, and he's like, oh, like, you'll feel right at home here. Like, I don't know. I guess a lot of people like go in there all the time from what it seemed like. But anyway, so the lady, the boss lady, I went up, and she was the one who, I'm sorry, I'm like rambling right now. I'm also really hot, so I'm trying to say this as quick as possible so I can hit the road. Oh, also, I filled up my tire. We're gonna see if it's okay. I might have to like go see. I once got a nail on my tire, and I just had to get it plugged, so hopefully it's nothing. Hopefully it just lost some air somehow, but we'll see. Sorry, I'm like a mess. I'm sweating and my skin is like not giving. Okay, anyway, back to the story. I go to check out, the guy like helps me get the horse, whatever. And she was just like, oh, you're so sweet. Like, do you like Briar horses? And I was like, oh yeah, I'm actually like interning for them right now. And she's like, oh my gosh, that's amazing. Like, where are you from? And I was like, say I go to school in Pennsylvania, but like I'm driving up to Fredonia. Which, like, I wasn't trying to tell anybody that, like, I'm not from around here. Because I feel like they tell you, like, not to say that. But, I mean, I was leaving and she seemed nice. Yeah, so she was like, she's like, okay, let's see what we could do here for you. And so she's like, how about we do 25 for both of them? I was like, yeah, that's great. Like, thank you. And she was just like, okay. And she's like, let's see what I could do here. She's like, I gave them to you for 20 because you're just so sweet. I was like, oh my god, thank you. Like, I got 2 Briar horses, one from the 60s, sorry, whoa, lighting. One from the 60s and a new in box Briar. Like, granted, neither of them are worth very much, but like, it was just so sweet. And she's like, oh, I hope you come back. Like, I'm gonna give you like stuff for, like, they have another location. And yeah, it was just really nice. She gave me like a coupon to the other location, so maybe I'll stop there on the way back if I'm feeling up to it. But yeah, guys, this is pretty big success. So I'm gonna go drive to my boyfriend's. We're only about an hour away now, so I should be able to push through. Hopefully my tire stays filled. And then I'll show you guys, I'll give you guys a closer look. And I think I could do like one of my little unboxing videos with the little vintage.
Great. Hello. 4 days later, I'm back home from my little vacation visiting my boyfriend. And I just wanted to give you guys a closer look at the ponies that I did end up getting. As I said before, I ended up getting 2 little ponies and I'm still just so excited about them. I have no clue where I'm going to put them in my room. Right now I have 1 traditional model with me, my Lady C, and then a handful of stable mates, and like, they're barely fitting, so I may have to clear off my desk a little bit to allow for some room. But I guess we'll start off with this little cutie. So this is a Proud Arabian, yes, or Family Arabian Foal, I think it's the Proud Arabian Foal, and he's just, the lighting is not giving. This cute little glossy guy. He had like such, I don't know, his face was so interesting to me because it's like such a perfectly like straight line down the middle. I have some little rubs here and there. He's obviously like a little dirty too, so I think he's gonna get a little bit of a bath, a gentle bath. Probably pretty easily like fix up the black rubs and stuff, but I didn't get him to show. It was just cause like, he is a model from the 60s and I don't have anything that old in my collection. He's little and cute and doesn't take up much space, so I thought he would be a good addition. Yeah, he was definitely played with or at least thrown around a little bit, but so cute. I do love this mold. It's just so adorable. And then this was the one I found new in box. It honestly might have been taken out of the box at some point, but he's still like zip tied in, so I'll take it. But it has the original store sticker, new for $19.99, and then this was like the price that I was supposed to pay. Yeah, we got the old Briar box. On this box it says $19.90, but I'm gonna
Maybe these like boxes were pre-made, I'm not sure.
And got the nice Made in the USA sticker. Sorry, this light is like not doing anybody any favors. But yeah, he was literally hiding behind like a shirt and like some box, but I know that iconic yellow box from anywhere, so of course I spotted him. So I am gonna do like a little unboxing short of him, just like when I have more time and can really like enjoy unboxing. But from what I see, he looks pretty perfect. I do not have a Missouri Foxtrotter in my collection. I just knocked something down. So I was really excited to add him for a really good price. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed following me on my little antique adventures. I absolutely love going to antique stores. It's seriously like one of my favorite things to do whenever we go on road trips. And it was my first time going solo, which was actually pretty fun. It was kind of nice to just be able to go at my own pace. I didn't end up going to any driving back. Just because it was a Monday, a lot of the bigger ones were closed, and I just wanted to get home. I was so tired. I am so tired. I still need to like shower and unpack and like prepare myself for the rest of the week. Keep an eye out for an unboxing video of this pretty boy. Make sure to leave a like if you enjoyed this video. Subscribe if you haven't already. And let me know in the comments what your best antique find has been. All right, that is all for today. Have a great rest of your day or night or morning, whenever you're watching this. I don't know when I'm going to end up editing it and uploading it. But yeah, stay fabulous, guys. Bye.